Hi, I'm Nina Carberry. I'm the winner of last year's Ladbrokes Irish Grand National and Organised Confusion. This year, I'm delighted to be Fairyhouse's ambassador. Welcome to my exclusive look behind the scenes at a race day here in Fairyhouse, my backstage pass. There's lots of women working in racing. Here's a few you're likely to meet on a normal race day here in Fairyhouse.
I do all Gordon's driving, and this will be my third season with him now. I do all his driving in Ireland and England. It can be pretty busy at times when he's runners all over the place. But yeah, no, it's great now. I love it. It's good to be carrying winners around, all right. Yeah, absolutely. It gives you a thrill when you're carrying horses around that are winning. It makes the job a lot easier when the boss is in good form as well after having a winner.
Saturday is a good, easy morning for me because obviously there's not much office work to be done, so I just get to come in and ride out in the morning, which is nice. But I kind of run the office as well, so weekdays will be very busy doing kind of entries, declarations and all that kind of stuff in the morning as well as riding out, so the morning's going to be very hectic. It's just such a buzz to be involved in and having what's essentially a hobby as a job. It's just great.
We start work first thing in the morning, where we load up all the gear that's to be taken out of the garage and stuff, loaded into the van for the guys that are racing that day. Head to the race course. We're normally here about 3 hours before racing, so hang up all the gear as you see, like their breeches and boots, and get saddles ready as you've seen me doing. And then obviously the lads start to come in, get changed a whole lot, then the collars come in, the pads and all that. So you're trying to get saddles ready for particular trainers and use the particular gear that they want to use. And then I suppose it's through the day, you're just literally rush, get them in, get them out. It is a great place to work. Like, it's a hard slog, don't get me wrong. But it's great coming in. The guys are really nice bunch of lads. They just accept the fact that there's a woman in a weigh room, they're walking around naked and they just get over it.
My job is as spokesperson for Ladbrokes is up to update everybody on what's happening in the betting in the morning, what's strong, the most heavily backed horses, and then after the races, if there's anti-post relevance, we may make a price change, be it for Cheltenham or for the Derby, and it's to update everybody about what's happening.
We're here in the background doing the regulatory work for the Turf Club. So I'm involved in the welfare of the horse, disease control, passport regulations, and we're also involved with drugs testing. Every horse in this country, and all thoroughbreds obviously, are identified by their markings, which are unique to each horse, but also now by a microchip number in later years since 1999. Horses that don't have any white markings can be quite difficult to differentiate from each other.
There's plenty of good girls coming up through the ranks, and there's a good few claiming seven coming up, and it's probably Kate Harrington and Jane Mangan that are leading the 7 pound claimers, and after that then it's Liz Lawler who's claiming five, and she's doing really well with her own horses, and she had her winner the other day in Turles, so she's doing brilliant, and Katie Walsh, she's probably one of the best anyway, so no, we're doing quite well, so hopefully a lot more women will come onto the scene.
I grew up in racing. My dad was a trainer. I was kind of useless. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't ride or train. All my friends could do those things. So I just always seemed to have a camera in my hands, so that's brought me into it. All I ever wanted to do when I was growing up, and they'd say to you, what do you want to do when you grow up? I used to say, I want to go racing every day. So it allowed me to do that, yeah. I always had a camera in my hand for some reason, and so I sort of fell into it. But I think the racing sort of came first, and the photography followed, you know.
So there's a lot more women in the last few years in racing, and it's great to see it. And it's great, again, as I said, to see Nina
female jockey winning the Irish Grand National. On a busy race day, my role involves various tasks from dealing with the Gardaí to on Taoiseach's arrival on the day of Grand National Day. And also I look after all the staff in the enclosure and the turnstiles and out to the car parks and security and cleaners here on the day. So it's quite busy for me, but very enjoyable and a great buzz around obviously on Grand National Day as well.
I'm a judge with the Turf Club, so my role is to arrive at the track an hour and a half before racing, mark up my card, check the distances, the time of the race, the jockey changes, non-runners. So I basically just have my card marked up to date with everything. Before each and every race, I check with the clerk at the scales for colour changes, cap changes. Then I go out to the parade ring and I would take the markings, the head markings of each horse. So if I arrive at a situation where I have two horses' heads very much close together in a photo finish, I can distinguish one from the other. As in, one might have a white snip around his nose, one might have an Australian noseband. So that's what I use my markings for.
About half an hour before the race time, I would go and get collect the saddle from the jockey in the weigh room and just have a chat to him about the ground and what our race plans are with the during the race, what we hope the horse will do. And then we go to the stable yard where we then saddle up the horse, check that the saddle's in the correct position and the horse's got the correct tack on and boots if they're jumping or what they need on. And then it heads to the horse heads to the parade ring where we then will meet the owners and hopefully decide what the plan is on that day and the expectations. And then the jockey comes in about 5 minutes before they get on the horse and they introduce them to the owner and discuss then what the jockey hopes that they're going to do.
The role of doctors on a race day is here to look for the welfare of the jockey should he fall, he or she falls, or and the welfare of the general public who pay in, that sort of thing. So generally on an ordinary race day there are two doctors. On a big premier meeting you might have three or four doctors depending on the attendance numbers as well. We have a minimum of three ambulances going round on the internal circuit, and as was said, it is probably the only professional sport that has such a medical team and such close proximity to a faller.
As you can see, there are many ladies involved in all areas of racing. We're giving the men a serious run for their money. I guess you can call it girl horsepower. I hope you enjoyed this backstage tour. I hope to see you racing soon.